the lame man had it was improved. Just some loaves, five little loaves and some fish. Matter of fact, and let me make it better, two sardines and five little biscuits.
Yeah,
I wish I had any y'all stuck up this morning.
Yes.
I need to find somebody in here that knows something about making it on a little bit. Since y'all trying to act foolish in here, trying to act like you ain't never been broke, and you see how God took a dollar and put some elastic in it and bless you and beyond measure. Can I get a witness? I thank God that God's still in the blessing business. Another miracle that it did, guess what? Walked on water. I want to help you with something. Whatever you do, don't take your eyes off Jesus. Can I get a witness? You'll sink every time. If you take your eyes off Jesus, he deals with restoring the sight to the blind, raising Lazarus from the dead. I need to pick up somebody here this morning. How many of you really can thank God when you thought that you was down and out?
Ooh, Lord.
Matter of fact, you felt you couldn't go no further. Matter of fact, your money was fun, change, strange. Friends all gone, guess what? God stopped by and raised you up. Hey, anybody here know he still can lift your head?
Yes, yes.
Come on, help me here. There, I got some folk in here. You have bowed down your head a long days. That he's still a lifter of your head. Matter of fact, y'all ain't talking to me. That's what matter died in your life. See when he show up and lift your head up. I wish I had somebody in. Lose a job. Go through a divorce. Go through a separation. Let your child get in trouble. Say it on God. Lift your head.
Yes, he will.
Lord have mercy. Then the miracle that happened after the resurrection.
All right.
Given the disciples an overwhelming catch of fish. Yeah. Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
I like that about the Lord.
Yeah.
Because when it looks like it's all over, the wrong side. I said, when it looks like it's all over, man, he can let you get a harvest of blessings. I know you sitting in the heart when we talk about Pastor ain't got no whole life, but I want to help you with something. You got you.
Yes, you.
And look, you got life. If you didn't get it right yesterday, you got another opportunity.
Another chance to get it right. Thank you.
Can I get it with you? Let me get somebody here that ain't going to act funny with me this morning. Even that you can thank God for small things. Anybody here thank God for walking that ain't good enough for you? Anybody here thank God for some ears to hear with? Anybody in here thank God for some eyes to see with? I wish I had somebody in here that thank God to just be able to wave your hand. Anybody in here, you didn't tell him good night last night, but he didn't fail to tell you good morning. He gets to this point in John 5. And John 5 is an interesting discussion for us today. John 5, the scribes, three festivals. Matter of fact, there was three festivals. One are called holy days, which were required of all of Judah to make sure you came to Jerusalem. Matter of fact, there was the festival of the Passover, as well as the festival of the unleavened bread. Then there was the festival of the Pentecost. midst of this part that I really love, it says, there was a feast of the Jews. And guess who showed up? Jesus went with him. I want to help you with something. Every now and then, you are at least invited. Can I hear a witness? I got some of you babies. Guess what? And you eat your food and never pray. Let me help you with something. You know when you get something out the canteen at the job? And some of you babies, guess what? You never pray when you get it. You think all the time you need to pray is in breakfast and in dinner. But if the Lord bless you with some nails. You ought to thank God for the nabs and the bob that Mountain Dew you get. Y'all
is going to. Yes, sir.
Is there anybody in here told God thank you lately for the Sprite, the Mountain Dew? Come on, the big red belly washer. I wish I had anybody in here that ever thank God for little stuff.
Yes, sir.
Lord, help me. Look what he says. It says, Jesus went up to Jesus. Bible says nothing about he went down. But he went up. God, I can't preach the word. He went up. Let me tell you something. Your head down this morning, he wants to go up. Matter of fact, guess what? He'll stay right with you until he lifts you up. There at Jerusalem, by the sheep market of Pooh, which is called in Hebrew tongue Bethesda, having five porches. And the sheep gate was a gate in the wall of Jerusalem.
All right.
That was somewhere near the temple to which the sheep was brought in for a sacrifice. And the pool of Bethesda was a pool surrounded by colonnades and four sides with a fifth colonnade standing in the dividing wall that separated the north from the south. Colonnades were row of columns that supported the roof. I want to help you with something. The five porches were colonnades on two sides with two on each side and one straight down the middle.
Yes, sir. All right.
Bible said there lay a great multitude. Remember that people there. Most people think that when you talk about impotent, guess what? You think of folk that don't have all their sexual activity. Oh, you can register now. But here, there are two other meanings. Before you even get to that. Matter of fact, the first meaning, according to Merriam-Webster, is unable to take effective action. Matter of fact, Webster says that your helpless, you, Lord help me, your powerless, you're ineffective, you're inadequate. He says that you're weak, you're feeble. I wish I had anybody here who ever felt like that you had some days in your life you feel like a failure. But I need to help you right there. Failure is not fine. Can I get a witness? And I want to tell you something. Even when you fail, there is a God and that is there to lift your heavy burdens. I want to deal with this and I'll move out your way. He says, a great multitude. Can I say that for a moment? A great multitude of folk in Cornerstone. a great multitude. He says, so, Lord, so if there's one, some blind folk. Matter of fact, some halt, some folk that's with him. Matter of fact, he said, guess what they were doing? They were there waiting. I need you down here. Waiting on the move. Of one. Can I say that for a moment? I got some babies in here this morning. You've been waiting a long time for your turning point. Good God. And it's a sad situation when you wait. And your problem with me this morning is, guess what? You waiting on other folk that ain't moving. Come on, help me here. And it's dangerous when you waiting on everybody else. Lord help us. But you ain't waiting on God to move. I won't come closer. And anybody in here ever needed God to speak to your situation? Well, that ain't good enough. Anybody here ever needed God to just speak to you and tell you what to do? Oh, that ain't good enough.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Anybody in here ever needed God to show up at the kitchen table, come in the living room, come in the bedroom, and just tell what it is you want me to do? Show up.
Yes, Lord.
As a matter of fact, guess what? I didn't got a new car, but guess what? You just need God to ride with you.
Ooh,
can
yeah,
you
can no.
smell the new car smell? Come on, here. Anybody here just ever needed God to? Yeah, come on here. Yeah, I know. I got all these folk in town. We worship the Lord in spirit, and we worship Him in truth. But guess what? There are days in your life you need God. You